Subscribe IN News English YouTube channel to all the big news of the world. Zack Snyder's Justice League will provide an explanation as to how Ben Affleck's Batman is able to fight off parademons during Steppenwolf's invasion of Earth. After Snyder stepped away from the project for personal reasons, replacement director Joss Whedon removed a number of scenes from the theatrical version. Several of these scenes were featured in trailers and teasers, leaving fans disappointed and hoping for their inclusion in the Snyder Cut. Those wishes are set to come true in 2021 when Zack Snyder's version of Justice League arrives on HBO Max. A fan movement developed through social media helped convince Warner Bros. To release the cut more than 3 years after it hit theaters to poor reviews and underperforming box office numbers. A teaser released back in August indicates that Snyder's vision will finally be realized. The restoration of scenes cut from the original film ensures that fans will be able to experience the film as the director intended. To mark the 3-year anniversary of Justice League's theatrical release, Zack Snyder held an online event breaking down the teaser trailer for his cut of the film. Streaming on Vero, Snyder offered an explanation for several scenes featured in the teaser, including one showing Batman facing off with parademons during the tunnel fight. Snyder detailed how the Dark Knight was able to go head-to-head with the extraterrestrials and fend off the blasts from their weapons. Alfred was able to construct for him special gauntlets. Of course, Wonder Woman, you know, they do discuss whose idea this was and what was the inspiration. It's pretty obvious where that idea came from. The theatrical cut of Justice League featured Batman fighting parademons on multiple occasions, but this particular scene did not appear in Joss Whedon's version. Batman using his gauntlets as a shield was also featured in Snyder's Batman v. Superman, Dawn of Justice, but was used to deflect bullets. The Batsuit has clearly gone through upgrades to deal with the stronger threat posed by parademons. By referencing both Alfred and Wonder Woman in his explanation, Zack Snyder helps flesh out both characters and the world he created. He provides another example of how hands-on Jeremy Irons' Alfred is in the DC Extended Universe. Fans have already seen the butler fixing Batman's cowl and piloting the Batwing in Batman v Superman, as well as controlling the Flying Fox in Justice League. The gauntlets, drawing inspiration from Wonder Woman's bracelets, also shows a level of collaboration among the heroes that did not come across in the theatrical version. It isn't clear if Snyder was referencing an actual scene that was filmed for Justice League or if his explanation is something the director created in his mind to justify Batman surviving a parademon battle. But with over 2 hours of new footage in the director's cut, there is a good chance a scene is included. In any case, it demonstrates Snyder's level of detail that was lost in the theatrical version of the film. With Justice League coming to HBO Max, fans will finally get to see the director's commitment pay off.